morning, guys. Good morning from my 8th national park. Okay, clearly there's someone who wants to be part of my intro, but yeah, no chance, you guys are gonna miss them later. So I'm in Mgahinga National Park in Kisoro district in Uganda. It is the smallest national park we have in Uganda, for the few minutes that I've been here, it seems to have more activities than the other national parks. Of course, it has the gorilla trekking. Yeah, you can also do gorilla trekking in this park. You can do golden monkey trekking. You can also do the battle trail. If you guys remember the battle we visited in Nature, yeah, there's another group in this forest. Then there is a nature walk and very many other activities that you are going to get to know in this video. Otherwise, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Let's do this.
So the original idea was to do a battle trail in Mgahinga, but an evening before on this bike, the rider told me that the road we're driving on is only a few minutes to the Congo border. He then went ahead to tell me that I can step into the country without even a passport or a national ID through an activity called the border walk in Mgahinga, and I was very intrigued. The next morning, I was up by 4 a.m, prepared myself since I had to get to the park by 7 a.m, yet I'd spent the night in the side of town, which is about 1.5 hours from the park. So I had breakfast and headed down the bumpy road to Mgahinga National Park.
Hi guys, so I have bad news. I just got to the park after like an entire hour of getting here. My eyes are swollen and I'm just being told that the activity might not be possible to be done today. Yeah, sorry, I got cut off. I received a call. Yeah, so that's what they told me. Then they told me first get to the offices and then talk to them and then see what they tell me. Hi guys, quick update. I wasn't able to do the is it called a border walk?
Border walk.
Yeah, I wasn't able to do a border walk, but a golden monkey trail was recommended, and I guess that's what I'm doing. The guys on the gate, they were not sure, but they said they doubt it can be possible. In office, they said the border walks have been suspended. Why were they suspended? Were people getting to the to the country illegally and keeping there and not coming back? What happened?
You know, the other neighborhood, the Congo is not safe. It's not safe.
Oh, so there were like political issues. Eh? So for how long has it been suspended? More than 2 years? Wow. People out there don't know. So far we've been at it for 1.5 hours. So the golden monkeys also need trackers like the gorillas?
Yes, exactly. We have a team there. They are ready there. They located them. They come every day.
Okay.
I have to go and follow them. But this golden monkey tracking is a bit hectic compared to gorilla
tracking. Yeah, you move more.
Well, for them, they can decide to jump and walk up in the branches and trees, unlike gorillas which can walk on the ground and make a trail. So when you are tracking golden monkeys, you have to be keen enough. You listen, you watch up. Yeah, you look at small slopes, small droppings and the leftovers. Look at those stuff.
Do they also move in families?
gorillas, golden monkeys live in troops. So this troop we are going to see is a big troop of between 80 to 120 Ooh. Members.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
And how many families?
Here we have, so far we have two troops. This one we have fully habituated and we use it. Then there's another one, another troop, which is under habituation. Mm. What we are going to do, we are going to collect the flash.
Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. And as always, you guys, if you have any questions, you can feel free to drop them in the comment section, and I'll be ready to answer your questions. And I hope you guys come and check out Mgahinga National Park, and yeah, plus other places that I've showed you guys from this side of the world. So see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.